Hello friends, welcome to our channel Brain Alive. In this video, we will discuss relationship between alpha, beta and gamma. Alpha, beta and gamma are the current amplification factors for different configurations of transistor. We know alpha is IC upon IE. This is output current upon input current. This is the current amplification factor for common base configuration. This is a circuit diagram of common base configuration. This is input side and this is output side. So IC is output current and IE is input current. So the current amplification factor is IC upon IE. And this is the circuit diagram of common emitter configuration. Here IC is output current because we are taking output across RL, and this is input current. IB is input current because we are giving input in this side. This is input circuit. So beta is equals to IC upon IB. We know IE equals to IB plus IC. This is because in a transistor, majority charge carrier from the emitter region reaches the collector region, and when they crosses this emitter junction, they reaches the base region. Here they combine with some of the holes in the base region and constitute base current. And when they reaches the collector region, after crossing this collector junction, they are swept by the positive terminal of VCC. So this constitute IC, means collector current, because these two currents IB and IC are due to the movement of electrons in the emitter region. So and they, these electrons are constituting emitter current. So this IE is the summation of IB and IC. Now after manipulating this equation, we will get IB equals to IE minus IC. Now we'll put this value, means this IB equals to this in equation, this one. So beta equals to IC upon IE minus IC. Now we will divide numerator and denominator by IE. Now the equation becomes IC upon IE upon 1 minus IC upon IE. So we know this IC upon IE equals to alpha. This is alpha equals to IC upon IE. So we will put IC upon IE equals to alpha, and here also, so 1 minus alpha here. So beta equals to alpha upon 1 minus alpha. This is the equation of beta in form of alpha. Now after cross multiplying this equation, we will get beta into 1 minus alpha equals to alpha. Then we will multiply this beta in the bracket and we will get this equation. Now we will take this term to the right side. So the equation becomes beta equals to alpha plus beta alpha. Now we will take alpha common and we will get this equation. Now we will take this term in the denominator on the right side. So the alpha equals to beta upon 1 plus beta. This equation shows alpha in form of beta. Now we will develop relationship between alpha and gamma. We know alpha is the current amplification factor for common base and gamma is the current amplification factor for common collector. This is the circuit diagram of common collector. Here this collector terminal is common on both sides, on output side and on input side. So IB is input current or IE is output current. So the current amplification factor is output current upon input current, that is IE upon IB. We know IE equals to IB plus IC. So after manipulating this, we will get IB equals to IE minus IC. Now we will put this value of IB in this equation. After putting this value, we will get this equation. Now we will divide numerator and denominator by IE. So we will get this equation. After solving this, we will get this one. This is 1 upon 1 minus IC upon IB. Now we'll put the value of this IC upon IE, and this is equals to alpha, because alpha equals to IC upon IE. So gamma equals to 1 upon 1 minus alpha. This equation shows gamma in form of alpha. Now we develop relationship between gamma and beta. We know gamma equals to IE upon IB and beta equals to IC upon IB, and also know IE equals to IC plus IB. Now we'll put the value of this IE in this equation. So this equation becomes gamma equals to IC plus IB upon IB. Now we'll separate these two terms and the equation becomes IC upon IB plus IB upon IB. These two cancels out. So now it is IC upon IB plus 1. So this IC upon IB is equals to beta. So gamma becomes equals to beta plus 1. So the relation is gamma equals to beta plus 1. This is the value of gamma in form of beta. I hope now you are able to develop the relationship between alpha, beta and gamma. If you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching the video.